Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Flat Hats at Home, bringing a little bit of Redwood National and State Parks to you and your home. I'm Ranger Brad. This week, two rangers have hatched up a pretty fantastic program for you guys about a special shorebird and their very unique eggs. It's going to be an amazing program. What is going on outside my window? Is that Ranger Sam? Up in the air? Hold on, I gotta check this out.
Incoming!
Whoa!
Whoa, Ranger Sam. Are you alright?
Yep, and it looks like my egg is too.
Great. Hello everyone, and welcome to this week's Flat Hats at Home episode. I'm Ranger Matt.
And I'm Ranger Sam.
And today we've brought you to a nesting colony of common murres in our living room.
2 weeks ago, Ranger Matt and I were exploring the beaches of Redwood National Park to see what we could find, and we found something really cool. This funky egg! We found this egg at False Klamath Cove as Ranger Matt and I were walking among the rocks. It was all by itself, cracked open, and a little hard to spot. Now, whenever I find something and I don't know what it is, I like to ask myself three questions. What do I notice? What do I wonder? And what does it remind me of? That way, I can learn a few things about this object just by looking closely. Ranger Matt, what do you notice about this egg?
Well, I notice it's mostly white with some black spots, and one end of the egg is much pointier than the other end of the egg is. And I bet if I roll it on the ground, it kind of spins like a top.
That's
pretty interesting.
Very cool.
What do you notice, Sam?
Well, I remember noticing that when we found it, it was very hard to spot among the rocks at the beach. I wonder if this is like camouflage.
Bet you're right. Oh, notice something else too. There's a big crack in this egg. Kind of reminds me of like cracking an egg for breakfast in the morning. That's pretty interesting. What do you notice about this egg?
So, after Ranger Matt and I were observing, we decided to do some more research to figure out what hip bird laid this funky egg.
This strapping young bird is a common murre. Don't let its black and white tuxedo fool you, though. This is no penguin. In fact, you can't find any penguins above the equator. Common murres are the dashing divers of the north, dressed in their best as they expertly dive for their dinners. Their black and white colors help to hide them from predators in the water. A hungry shark looking up at a murre's white belly might not be able to distinguish it from the sun's glare through the water. Looking down, a murre's black back blends in with the darkness of the deep water below. When they've had their fill of small fish and evaded the big, hungry ones, common murres return home to rest on their nests.
Now, have you ever shared a room with a sibling or a friend? Do you remember how crowded it felt to share a whole room with just even one person? Now, imagine sharing a room with 40,000 people. That's what life is like for common murres. Being seabirds, common murres like to live on rocks and make nests on them when they're surrounded by the sea, a pretty hot commodity here in California. When a suitable rock is found, everyone wants a piece of the pie. Common murres have to crowd themselves wing to wing on many of these rocks, even while nesting. They are the densest colony nesters of any bird in the world.
Now we know that murres are really good divers, and that they can fly pretty well too, but there's something they're really bad at, landing. They crash every time, just like Ranger Sam showed us. And for any other bird, a crash landing would crack or crush their eggs. But the common murre's egg is able to take a beating. Take a look at this pointy shape and these really straight sides. These eggs don't balance on one point like other eggs do. Take this chicken egg, for example, perfectly balanced on its rounded sides. If a 2-pound bird crashed down on this chicken egg, we'd be having scrambled eggs for breakfast. But for a murre's egg, its straight sides evenly distribute the force of the impact, making it far less likely to crack or crush.
Wow. So, we have found a well-engineered, oddly shaped egg that can take a punch. Great, but now there's another problem. How will a murre find its egg among 40,000 other eggs? Common murres have developed a solution to this problem. They uniquely color their own eggs. Mother murres memorize the patterns and colors of their egg, so they know how to pick it out in a very big crowd. We can see that this egg is faintly green with black marks. All murre eggs have different patterns of black marks, but the shell can also be white, pink, or even a little blue. Every murre can identify its egg because it's unique from the rest.
Now, we invited you all to color your own murre eggs and share them with us. As promised, if you colored an egg, it's somewhere in this colony. Channel your inner murre and you might be able to find your unique design sticking out among the rest.
Hey, say, Ranger Matt, I think it's about time to go get some more fish. What do you think?
It sounds great to me. Thanks, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you so much, Rangers Matt and Sam, for those awesome common murre facts. And thank you to everybody else that submitted those amazing egg designs that were used in this video. If you have any questions about common murres or their eggs, drop them in the comments below and we'll be happy to answer those for you. Now join me next week as we talk about everybody's favorite redwood critter, banana slugs. We're going to learn about why they're actually important to the ecosystem of Redwood National and State Parks. Thanks again for joining us for another episode of Flatheads at Home, bringing a little bit of our home to yours.
If you enjoyed this video, give us a like or maybe even give us a share. Redwood National and State Parks is committed to bringing as much of our park to your home as we can during this unprecedented time. So please stay healthy and stay safe.